Hello, this is Michael Sulak again. The purpose of this video is going to be to mainly go through an example called simple linear regression. Regression is a fancy idea to talk about a model to make predictions. Simple linear regression requires that you are dealing with two quantitative variables. So let's just jump right into the example I want to do. We are going to be using the weight of a vehicle, that's our first quantitative variable, to predict a vehicle's miles per gallon. And we're going to be looking at some data and creating what's called this simple linear regression line. Weight is doing the explaining, miles per gallon is doing the responding. I've found a data set with these two variables. One of the first things we like to do, make a graph of these. We're going to put the explanatory variable on the x-axis and the response variable on the y-axis. I have a data set of 144 cars from 2009. And we have the values of these two variables. We have their weights in one column and their miles per gallon in the other. We even have what models they are, which is kind of cool, but I'm not really going to be worrying about what model is what. We're just going to take these points right now and put them on a scatter plot. So every one of these cars is going to have a point where the x coordinate of that point is its weight and the y coordinate of that point is its miles per gallon. So for instance, this Lamborghini Murcielago, it's a pretty light car, 1650. The unit here is important. These are in kilograms. So we're going metric here, people. I know the United States is the only country that doesn't use kilograms, but a kilogram is about 2.2 pounds. So if you want to know what this is in pounds, you could just about double it. So it weighs about 3,300 pounds. And this car does not get super good miles per gallon. It is designed to go fast, not to be efficient. So every one of these cars is going to get a point. So let's see what this thing looks like, this scatter plot, once we stick all 144 cars on there. So here's our plot. There are 144 dots on here. They are a little bit clumped together in certain places. But you can see that here's that Lamborghini. Our goal here is basically to establish a relationship between vehicle weight and highway miles per gallon. These are all basically sedans. And so what we try to do is to do what we call fit a line that is going to go right through the middle of these data points. And it's going to be what we call our simple linear regression line. Sometimes you might see that abbreviated as SLR. The formula for a line, if you do it in your calculator, it's going to give it to you like this, where A is the slope. Every line has a slope. That tells you how steep this thing is. And then every line has a y-intercept, which is what would happen if you continued this line all the way up. Where would it intersect the y-axis here? For this equation, the value of the y-intercept is this b. So when you put this data into your calculator, you will get it out a simple linear regression line, and they'll give it to you in this format. So I'll show you how to do that. If we ask you to calculate simple linear regression lines, we will give you fewer data points than 144. That would be cruel.
Okay, so here's our TI-83. If you have a TI-84 or something like that, the process is still going to be fairly similar. We need to get the raw data into this thing. So we're going to hit stat, and we're going to hit edit, and then we need to put the explanatory variable in L1. So this is going to be different from how it appears in our spreadsheet here. We're going to put the weights first because that's my explanatory variable. I'm just going to do a few. I'm putting in the value of weights. I'll say do the first five cars here. Ooh, this is a weird one. So I've done stat edit and I've inputted the raw data. And then I need to press stat again, and I'm gonna go over to calc, and I wanna go to linreg for linear regression. Going to go down and select that, or you could just hit the number 4, hit enter, and there I have my simple linear regression line. Just for these few points here, they're telling me that, okay, the general form is y equals ax plus b, but I know a and I know b, so I could say my simple linear regression line. And a lot of times we put this hat on the y, this caret looking thing, because it's a predicted value. We're not saying y is actually equal to this. Once we use this equation, we're using a model, and that model is making predictions. These are not observed values of miles per gallon, our y variable. So we get y equals, I'm just going to round this to a few places, times x plus 90.15. So that is my simple linear regression line. And sometimes you might see it written out, which I think is slightly more helpful. Instead of using x and y, we might write it like this. Our predicted miles per gallon is equal to our slope times not just any x, but the weight plus the intercept. So this format, just, it's a little bit more in context of the data. It tells you what variable is which. It reminds you that weight is the explanatory and miles per gallon is the response. But either one of these formats, if this was on an exam, would be totally fine. This line right here that I just found came from only putting in 5 data points. So what I want to look at is the model if you use all 144 data points. God forbid, if you had to do this in your calculator, you would just have to put in 144 lines of data. So here's the scatter plot again with the simple linear regression line using all 144 vehicles from the data set. And this is some output from a different piece of software finding the simple linear regression line. So in your calculator, it would have given you this value as the b, because that's the intercept, and this value turns out to be the slope. That would have been your a in your calculator. So our actual simple linear regression line using all 144 data points is going to look like the predicted miles per gallon is going to be my slope, which is negative, which is what we expect. I'm going to round that slope just a little bit, times weight plus the y-intercept, which is 44.15. And that kind of looks like it makes sense. If this line continued, it looks like it would probably end up hitting this y-axis at about 44.15. So that is the equation of this blue line here, and that's going to be our model. And we can use that to make predictions. If we knew a car, say, weighed 3,000 kilograms, let's find its predicted miles per gallon. 3,000 kilograms would be kind of off the range of this chart here, but you can see that its prediction is going to be the y value on this blue line, and it's going to be fairly low. It looks like it might be about, say, down here maybe, because that would be if I imagined weight continuing. It might be something like that. But anyway, let's just figure it out exactly by putting the value of 3,000 kilograms into our regression line. Predicted miles per gallon is going to be... So all I'm doing is taking the value of the explanatory variable that I want to predict for and just putting it into my model for in the right place for x or for the value of weight. And we end up getting a value of 11.45. So like we expected, this model predicts that a car that is fairly heavy, 3,000 kilograms, that's over 6,000 pounds, is going to get low miles per gallon. And to find predictions, you first need to create the model, which is a fancy sounding term for come up with the equation, the line, and then you take the value that you want to predict for and put that into that equation and solve, and you get the predicted value. So we have this simple linear regression line, and we might want to know, hey, we're making all these predictions. How good are they? Does this model seem to be reasonable? Is this giving us useful information? And one way we can do this is by finding what we call the residual for a given data point. And so what that might look like is something like this. We might be asked to, hey, find the residual for the Lamborghini Murcielago, that fancy sports car. So what a residual is you have a data point, and that data point might not be sitting perfectly on the line. And the residual is just the distance that point is from the line. It just gives us a rough idea of how close did this line come to the actual observed data value for this data point. So that distance is what's known as the residual. How you find that is all you have to do is take the value of the observed data point, the y value for it, and subtract the predicted y value. And so you might see this as y minus y hat, because the y hat is the predicted value. We know the observed value for the Lamborghini. It is, there's the Lamborghini, and its observed is 14. And so we just need to find the predicted value by putting its weight into our model. So the observed value would be the 14. And then we just need to find the predicted value. And when we do that, I get 26.165. So every data point that you have has a residual, and for this data point the residual is negative because the Lamborghini was below the line, and the distance that it was below the line was 12.165 miles per gallon. So the line didn't do a super good job of predicting this value, but if you think about it, this Lamborghini is a little bit atypical. It doesn't get as good gas mileage as most cars. If we go back and look at the data set, our line, most cars were way up here, and that Lamborghini got worse gas mileage in general. So the distance that point is below the line ended up being quite a bit over 12 miles per gallon. So a couple of last things we might want to do with a regression line is interpret what the numbers and it mean, the slope and the intercept. And when we say interpret, we mean talk about it in the context of the data. Let's look at the slope first. So interpret in the context of the data, the slope. The slope of a line is something we sometimes call the rise over the run. For this line that we have, that slope is equal to negative 0.0109. Which means that we could think about that as being a fraction where the bottom is 1 and the top is negative 0.0109. Our run here is 1 and our rise here is actually going down by negative 0.0109, not very much. So I just want to interpret that. So what is that? That's the change in predicted miles per gallon when weight goes up by one thing, by one unit, by one kilogram. So what I want to say is that this model, which has a slope of negative 0.0109, this model predicts that if weight goes up by 1 kilogram, then our predicted miles per gallon is going to decrease by just a little, by this amount. Basically, we're just saying, hey, if X goes up by 1 unit, which in this case is weight, then Y is going to go down, which in this case is predicted miles per gallon, is going to go down by just a little bit. And a few important points about interpreting the slope is that you definitely want to mention that this is a prediction. We don't know that this is perfectly going to happen. We're using a crystal ball here, and there's a chance we could be wrong. And you also need to mention that this value, the value of the slope, is only true for one unit increase in the explanatory variable. For a car that weighs 100 kilograms more, we predict the miles per gallon is going to go down by 100 times this, by 1 mile per gallon. So, and when you're interpreting the slope, just make sure that you talk about a one unit increase in X. Now let's interpret the Y-intercept. And just as a reminder of what the y-intercept is that it's the value where the line crosses the y-axis. So this line crosses the y-axis at 44.15. So that line crosses the y-axis at 44.15. So what does that mean in terms of this data? And it turns out that sometimes the y-intercept is useful and sometimes it's not. And in this case, it's going to sound a little bit funny when we interpret what the y-intercept is in the context of this data. Because if we're up here and we are at the point right on the y-axis, well, what's the value of our x variable here? It's zero. Any point on the y-axis has an x value of zero. The y-intercept of our line is the value of the predicted miles per gallon for a car that weighs nothing, has a zero weight. And I know that's absurd, pretty funky, but we're just gonna write it out anyway. So what is it? Our model predicts a car that weighs 0 kilograms will get 44.15 miles per gallon. That is the interpretation of the y-intercept in the context of this problem. And of course that is absurd. No cars weigh 0 kilograms. And it's good to even think about the fact that that is absurd, because what that is a concept known as extrapolation. That is really outside the scope of where we think this model is actually useful. We measured cars that weren't anywhere near the y-axis. All of our cars were out, you know, they were out in here somewhere. And that value of the y-axis is way outside the scope of our data. Our data was in this sort of range, and then this prediction is way outside that range. So anyway, just the fact that these models are useful, which they are, it's best to use a simple linear regression line to make predictions that are somewhat near the range of your data. And if you try to make a prediction that's very outside that, you're doing what's called extrapolating. So, as a quick review, what did we do? We used two quantitative variables, weight and miles per gallon, to make a regression line. And that regression line is used to make predictions of the response variable using a value of the explanatory variable. And this is the start of a large part of statistics of making all sorts of models. The simple linear regression model is one of the most basic models. And it's the model that we use in this class because we can find it fairly easily. Our calculator will find the line for us. And once we have it, we can use it to make predictions, say for a car that weighs 3,000 pounds by putting that value into the model, and we get out the predicted Y, the predicted miles per gallon. And then we could check how close that prediction was to an actual value by finding a residual. The residual is the distance from the observed value to the predicted value, always in this order. It's always observed minus predicted. So any point that's below the line has a negative residual, and any point above the line has a positive residual. And then lastly, the interpretations are something that we might ask you to do. They can be a little bit interesting, especially the interpretation of the intercept for this sort of data. That was basically simple linear regression in a nutshell. And I know there's a lot there, but the more you practice, the more familiar you become with everything. And I hope this video was helpful. This is Michael Sulak, and I will see you next time.